Hello everyone, I have Chayanpreet with me today and we are going to talk about the IELTS exam. So welcome to the session, Chayanpreet, and let us quickly begin with your introduction.
Hi, thank you so much Deepa for introducing me. My name is Chayanpreet and I am an English language consultant working globally for helping students to clear their IELTS, PT, and TOEFL exams.
Right. So, before we start talking about the nitty-gritties of the IELTS exam, let us try to quickly understand what exactly is IELTS and why is it important for students who want to study abroad?
Sure. IELTS is an acronym for International English Language Testing System. Mm-hmm. And it is generally undertaken by non-native speakers of English, which I mean to say that it is undertaken by candidates who either wish to study abroad or wish to migrate for settling down there, which is also for a professional purpose.
All right. So what is the structure of the exam and for how long does a test take to complete?
So let me first tell you that there are two types of IELTS exams. One is the academic IELTS and the second is the general IELTS.
Okay.
Academic IELTS is given by students who wish to pursue their education abroad in these English-speaking countries, which I was talking about earlier. The general exam is also given by candidates who wish to migrate for professional purposes or for searching a job.
Right.
Now, coming to the structure of the IELTS exam, it is spread across four modules: reading, listening, writing, and speaking. Now, reading, listening, and writing tests are conducted on a single day in a duration of 3 hours. And if I segregate the duration for each and every module, let's see, writing is for 60 minutes. Reading is again for 60 minutes. Listening is for 35 minutes. That is what it makes. That is how it makes 3 hours in total. And now coming to the speaking exam. Speaking is conducted either a week before or after the writing, listening, and reading exam. And it is conducted in a duration of 15 to 20 minutes.
Okay. So, I want to understand, you are an online IELTS tutor, and how many students have you taught so far?
Till now, I have worked with around hundreds of students, nationally and internationally both. My students are spread across Asia, Europe, and India. So I work with all these students for helping them out to clear both these types of exams, whether it's academic or general.
Wow. So you have worked with more than 100 students. So that is a considerable amount of experience coming to IELTS coaching. And what has been the most challenging experience in your career as an IELTS coach?
That one is definitely a question that my students should hear. 50% of my students, the candidates that I with, come to me saying that they should be spoon-fed with answers for essays or for write-ups, for which my answer is absolutely a big no. I always allow them to be as creative as possible, because the trainer won't be sitting beside them in the exam hall. So I always recommend all my students to be as creative, as natural, and as confident in their exams in all the four modules, reading, listening, writing, and speaking. I always recommend them to be totally creative, whether it's in the class or in the exam hall.
All right.
So the second issue with 9 out of 10 students, I feel, is that if they are not ready with their grammar skills, if they are not very confident about their grammatical skills in English, I always suggest them to first undertake a capsule course in grammar with me before commencing their IELTS classes, which is definitely very helpful. Because once we have the foundation set right, we can move ahead very smoothly with the IELTS course. Let me tell you, because this course is an English language test. And for preparing you for this course, we must have our foundation right. So foundation is built with good grammar skills, with good vocabulary. So again, this is all a part of the beginner's English language course for which I am always ready to help them.
Okay, so have you seen that by taking these capsule courses for grammar, the way the students have approached the exam, has that changed before and after?
Immensely. I would say it creates an everlasting impact on their English language skills, because the confidence suddenly plunges when you have your grammar right. So automatically you become more fluent, you become more confident in your speech. You don't keep on just searching for words and the structure. You don't keep on thinking whether I'm writing right or wrong. So the effect is not only just one skill, but all the four skills. You listen better, you comprehend better, you read better, you get good scores. And definitely all that is just the result of good grammar.
Absolutely, absolutely, Chayanpreet. I cannot agree more, because what I feel is like having your grammar correct is like having a right foundation for the English language exams. And if you are going to another country where English is the language of communication, then one should be equipped with the language. So the purpose of taking the IELTS, I think, is not just about the exam, it is also being able to operate in the country once you're there.
Absolutely, because once you move out, you will meet all the people speaking in English. So English is going to be the only mode of communication for you guys. And whether it's colleges, whether it's your school, whether it's your job, so you will have to interact with each and every single person in English. And right. That'll be much more comfortable. That'll be a smooth sailing journey for you once you have your language in place.
Right. So, as a last question for this session, what are the what are the key tips that you would want to give to the students who are considering the IELTS exam?
So definitely I would want to recommend some things to you. Let me bifurcate them for two stages. The one can be the planning stage, that is before the paper, before you sit in the examination hall actually. And the second is going to be the execution stage, once you are into the hall and once you start writing your exam. So the first is, of course, going to be for the planning stage. I always recommend my students to surround themselves with English language, whether it's in the form of movies or books or journals or with their English speaking friends. All these things are really fruitful. They're really helpful for your exam, because they don't only make you eligible for the exam, confident for the exam, but also after that. Once you enter into a different country, you will have to do all this anytime. So be ready for all of that. And all of this definitely will improve your English language skills for the paper and for after the paper. The next thing would be to focus on time. We should not just sit with one paper for hours and hours at a stretch, but set a time frame accordingly, according to the structure of your test. And just solve your paper in that much time, because time management is definitely the key to score good in your exam, whether it's reading, listening, writing, or speaking. The next thing should be to practice very hard for these exams and practice from the authentic resources, either from the British Council or IDP. We must always rely on authentic sources for these practice papers. So this was for the planning stage. Now let me talk a little about the execution stage also. Because once you enter the exam, the environment is different. The factors that are that you are surrounded by are different. So we must not lose our calm. Be confident that you're going to do well, you're going to score well. We know that whenever we are practicing at home, at our comfort zone, everything is good, we score well, the scores are consistent, but they should remain consistent throughout the exam also. So we must not be afraid of all the external factors for the that will be there in the exam hall. And next would be to remain confident yet again and be as natural as possible. Don't try to imitate anyone. Don't try to imitate an accent. Be as natural as you are. Be confident and always wear a smile. So the last two things that I recommended were especially for the speaking exam, because while speaking, we start stammering, we start losing out our confidence, and things start getting difficult for us. So in that situation, we must always try to be calm and try to interact with the examiner and try to speak more than the examiner. Don't stop. Don't stop speaking. Let the examiner listen to you and enjoy your speech. So that is all what I can, what I recommend my students. So these are definitely the top key tips for my students.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Chayanpreet. And I'm sure these tips are going to help the students a lot. And once again, thank you for joining me for this session. And we hope that we keep talking to you again over the next sessions.
My pleasure, Ms. Deepa.